All right, YouTube, I want to give you guys three of my favorite dividend stocks for 2019 and beyond. Now, these might not be the super high yielding stocks that offer a 6% return, but I don't look for those kind of companies. I look for companies that give you share price appreciation and a consistent dividend. And I look at I go to dividend.com and I look at Dividend Aristocrats. And these are stocks that have a long track record of raising their dividend year after year after year. And a lot of times too, I look at stocks that have weathered recessions. I don't want to buy a stock we could be going into a bear market soon. We've been in a 10-year bull. So if you go into a bear market, or if the economy goes into a recession, which it's cyclical, it will eventually, you don't want to be stuck owning a company that doesn't have a very good balance sheet and is going to slash its dividend. No, you want to look for a company that even in a recession has had a track record of raising its dividend. So the three stocks I'm going to offer today are PepsiCo, Starbucks, and AbbVie. Okay, so the three metrics that I like to look for on dividend stocks, I like to look at the operating margins, make sure the operating margins are not declining. You don't want to own a stock that is becoming less profitable, a company that's becoming less profitable. You want to make sure the free cash flow as percentage of sales is strong, and there's not a decrease there. And you want to look at the return on invested capital, so what the company is doing with its shareholder money, and if they're generating solid returns. Now, if you would have looked at GE, you would have seen a red flag in all these metrics, and you might have been able to sell the stock long before this huge decline. So, and GE had like a 6% dividend, and dividend investors were going into it, but the free cash flow wasn't very good, and lo and behold, they ended up slashing their dividend in half. So, not a good company to own. But the reason I like PepsiCo is very simple. They make multiple brands. Pepsi Soda, Quaker Oats, Gatorade. They started investing in kombucha. They have a stake in Sabra Hummus. They have Frito-Lay. They're extremely profitable. And in good economies, people are going to eat. Bad economies, people are going to eat as well. They offer a yield of 3.3% and have raised their dividend for 46 straight years. And if you've owned the stock for the last decade like I have, you would have also had a 118% return in share price appreciation on top of that dividend. So, very good company. The next company I want to bring up is Starbucks. Starbucks, have you ever driven past one or gone in a store and not seen it completely full? It's expanding into China right now, which is worrying people with this trade war going on, but I don't think people are going to stop drinking Starbucks coffee because there's a trade war going on, so I think it's an overreaction. It yields 2.2%, but if you've owned it for the past 10 years, you've had a 1,263% return in share price appreciation. So once again, a pretty solid company. I would be willing to bet that no matter how bad a bear market is, Starbucks is not going to go under. The final company I was going to bring up is AbbVie. They're a maker of Humira. Humira is a drug for autoimmune diseases. The baby boomer generation is getting older, and autoimmune diseases are plaguing society right now. And Humira is the number one selling drug in the world. So I know there's some fears about generic competition, but AbbVie has raised their dividend for 4 points. They've raised their dividend for 46 straight years. It's a 4.6% yielder, and they've also offered you 143% in share price appreciation over the past decade. On top of splitting, it was AbbVie with Abbott Labs. So those are my three dividend stocks for 2019. Please leave a comment below. Comment some of your favorite dividend stocks. And make sure you check out our website for our investors newsletter. We've been putting a lot of work in that. Whenever we get a suggestion, we really take it to heart because we realize that this YouTube channel is nothing without viewers. And if you guys want us to do something, we're going to do it. So leave comments below, and we look forward to hearing from you guys. So everybody have a nice week. Thank you.